Hi everyone, I'm Shikin. Welcome back to our YouTube channel. Now, you're watching episode 3 of the Mud Crab Show. Last episode, we already shared with you on the biology of mud crab. If you haven't watched the previous episode, you can find the link at the description. In this episode, we will be discussing why recirculating aquaculture system, RAS, vertical farming was introduced. In traditional mud crab farming, the farm must be located near the brackish water sources where the tidal exchange is crucial in maintaining water quality. However, due to challenges faced in the traditional pond system and supply chain, many have adopted RAS to overcome these constraints. As you might have known, the mud crab nature is cannibalism. When overcrowded in the pond, mud crab would cannibalize each other and resulting in high mortality. The cannibalism can be reduced by making a vertical crab house, where only an individual of mud crab is placed in one crab house. This also can save the land requirement in comparison to traditional pond farming. This technology is suitable if you have land scarcity. Here is my colleague Nabila, and she will show you how to take out the crab from the crab house. Here is one of our mud crabs. You can also opt to utilize this vertical crab farming technology for soft shell crab production, where mud crabs are also placed in the box. This is to minimize the space requirement of the large pontoon and pond areas. Next, the RAS technology can help to buffer against fluctuation in natural brackish water. We know the natural brackish water ecosystem can fluctuate the salinity, temperature and other essential nutrient content through tidal change. This can be improved by applying RAS, as the water will have minimal water exchange. In addition, RAS technology can help to control water quality and water condition. Water quality in the traditional pond farm can be difficult to manipulate at times due to the large amount of water. The parameters are also highly dependent on weather pattern and the lunar cycle. Mud crabs require water in good quality and quantity to ensure high survival rates and fast growth. Here is the water sample from our system. By using RAS, we can control the salinity by adding sea salt. For temperature, RAS provides a more stable environment for mud crab, as the temperature difference are in the range of plus minus 2 to 3 degrees. The dissolved oxygen also improves, as this system might consist of either blower aeration, venture aeration or oxygen concentrator. Here, to control pH, we use low quantity sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate might be more expensive than quicklime or dolomite, but it is more effective. And since we have a low amount of water, only a little sodium bicarbonate is needed to maintain pH. For the toxic ammonia, RAS use biofilter to convert the toxic ammonia to another form of less toxic compound. Besides, RAS has been a popular technology due to low water exchange, and it can be located anywhere. Without human intervention, the quality of culture water tends to deteriorate over time due to feeding. Like any metabolic activity, the culture species produce waste in the form of ammonia that accumulate in the culture water. In traditional pond, these accumulated waste are expelled from the pond via tidal exchange. Upon the rising tide, clean water is introduced into the pond, thus displacing the ammonia-contaminated culture water. Hence, this restricts the culture of marine species in areas without direct access to seawater. With recent advance in wastewater treatment, recirculating aquaculture system has enabled a recycling of the cultured water a possibility. This eliminates the need for water replacement and hence removing the location barrier. This reduces the operating cost by reducing transportation and salt usage, but requires more upfront capital for the recirculating aquaculture system, RAS. Furthermore, the introduction to RAS can reduce complicated supply chains. The demand for mud crab is the highest in cities like Singapore, Malaysia, Hong Kong and etc. The majority of the supplies originate from Indonesia, Philippines, India and Vietnam. Thus, mud crabs are usually transported via air freight to reach the consumer. Mud crabs are typically moved through multiple aggregator, exporter, importer and distributor. In some extreme cases, the duration from harvest to end consumer can sometimes take 5 to 6 days. By applying vertical mud crab farming, which is focusing on the crab fattening process, we can reduce the supply chain by directly purchasing the water crab from the exporters. Usually, the water crab will be rejected from packing and sold at a lower price. According to FAO, the empty mud crab are graded as commercially unsuitable crab. The last reason why RAS vertical farming was introduced is to ensure that mud crab products are full without delaying pond production. Pond production generally focuses on the growth out of mud crab, while vertical farming focuses on crab fattening. Grow out usually takes more than 3 months before harvesting period. As the vertical farming with RAS work differently, we can eventually support the pond production as fast as 2 weeks of the fattening period. In this case, we can ensure that the mud crab consumer will have a continuous supply for the mud crab without delaying the pond preparation. Now, we are already at the end of this episode. To recap, in this episode, we already understand the reasons why RAS vertical farming was introduced. The reasons are to reduce the land space need, buffer against the fluctuation in natural breakage water, control water quality, low water exchange, shorten the supply chain, and to ensure continuous production. In the next episode, we will share with you the boxes or crab house. Do subscribe to our channel to get notification on the next episode. If you have any question, drop it in the comment section. Thank you for watching.